Hey, what is going on, Fan Clan? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Danny Phantom, and I hope you guys all had a wonderful weekend. Happy Monday. I want to get right into things today. We're going to be talking about graded cards, PSA graded cards in specific. I know there's a lot of other options that you can use, whether it be Beckett, whether it be CGC, which kind of sprouted up over the past year and really came at a good time because of all the demand that was going behind getting cards graded. When I first started getting back into Pokemon after taking several years off, it was right around the Roaring Skies, Phantom Forces era, and I was kind of looking at playing the game competitively. I started doing a lot of research on different chat forums and different websites, social media websites, Facebook, just to get a better understanding of what was going on in the meta, what was going on in the format, what I needed to know. When I was younger, I enjoyed collecting the cards, but I also enjoyed playing the competitive game. I wasn't somebody who went around to tournaments when I was younger by any means, but that was something that kind of started sparking my interest a little bit as I got older. So once I started getting back into things around Phantom Forces, Roaring Skies, I started thinking, oh, maybe it would be fun to start going to some tournaments, playing in some events. I started going to a local league occasionally just to get a better feel for what was going on, and really met a wonderful group of people that are still my friends to this day, and just kind of showed me the ropes, showed me what to do, showed me what to expect, because I had never been to a major tournament before. Started going off to I went to Wisconsin States 1 year and did very poorly in that, playing Metacham, but it was a lot of fun to play it. And then I started going to a couple of regional events here and there. And then once I started realizing how much it took to be a competitive player, especially from a professional level, and seeing how much travel you need to go into it, I decided, okay, maybe getting involved in Pokemon from a business standpoint might be a better idea for me, because I'm not going to be able to go around to a lot of different tournaments and things like that as I get further along in life. It's not to say that I'm not going to go to any events. I might still play in the occasional tournament here and there, which is what I have done since then, but not as much as I necessarily would like to if I was younger. But with that being said, I focused a lot when we started a business on competitive play and competitive staples and things that I knew that would sell and things I knew that the competitive world needed access to. And I think that's still a really important part of the game. But for a long time, I kind of shied away from the collector market because I didn't really know a whole lot about the collector market, specifically around graded cards. It just wasn't something that I knew a lot about, and it wasn't something that I thought anybody really knew a whole lot about, because when I came to graded cards, I thought, okay, well, you get comic books graded, you get sports cards graded, but there wasn't really a whole lot of market for Pokemon. Fast forward to over the past year, and all of a sudden that has been destroyed. That thought process has been destroyed, and it's almost gotten to the point now where it might be kind of causing more harm than good. And this is kind of an opinionated video, and I wanted to get your thoughts on it all, on what you think about grading cards and what cards you should be grading, because I get that question a lot, and I think it's important that people realize that they should be collecting what is important to them, what they want to collect, and they should be focusing on getting those cards graded to kind of solidify that condition of the card for eternity. If you're collecting cards and you're like, oh, I'm somebody who's probably not going to be getting rid of this card for a long time, and if I do, I want it to at least maintain its condition, then I do think grading cards is really important. But I think over the past year, we have gotten into this mentality of we need to grade anything and everything that comes out of a pack, just because that way it's going to be worth money. And we've really used this whole money aspect of everything revolving around grading cards, and I think that's kind of a poor way of looking at the whole graded market, because I think it actually does the opposite and starts decreasing the value of cards. Because once you start grading a $1 or $2 card, if you're looking at paying, you know, the membership fees, and then you're looking at paying the grading fees, which we're going to look at in just a few minutes here as well, it really comes to the point where you're kind of losing money in the long run. And all of a sudden we get all these slabs that are out on the market that are just kind of junk slabs. And I think that's kind of an era that we're starting to get into as PSA starts delivering more and more of these cards and returning them back. And there's still a lot to go. There's a number that I saw last night that kind of shocked me that I want to share with you guys in just a little bit when we go over the population report and things like that. But there's a lot of cards that still need to come back from PSA. And this is just PSA. This isn't counting BGS. This isn't counting CGC. This isn't counting, you know, any of the other GMA or any of the other grading companies that have recently launched or that have been in existence for a while. This is just PSA that we're going to be talking about here. So first, I want to draw everybody's attention over to an article on Polygon. And this article was in April, so it's a couple months old already. But I do think it's important. It's something that we haven't talked about before. So I kind of wanted to bring it up and see what everybody's thought process is when it comes to grading Grading cards just isn't something that I've done a lot of in the past, and I still don't have a lot of experience for it, which is why I've kind of defaulted to a lot of other people in the past, like Charlie Herlocker from Ludkins and other grading companies that are out there, because I don't know a whole lot about that market. We don't own a whole lot of graded cards. We might have 25, 30 cards. You know, we don't have anything that's like super, super high end, like a PSA 10 first edition Charizard or anything like that. We might have like a Crystal Charizard or a Shining Charizard, a couple of good cards that are really important to us that we just thought, hey, we should get these graded so that way it encapsulates them in that condition. But I do want to look over at this article quick, and I'm just going to kind of read through a decent chunk of it. But it says, retailers can't keep Pokemon cards on their shelves. Rare cards are selling for hundreds of thousands of dollars at auctions. McDonald's is overwhelmed with nostalgic adults buying up Happy Meals to collect card packs, steaming with hot fries inside a cardboard box. The Pokemon card industry, which had existed since 1999, has boomed over the past year right alongside sports trading cards. The rush is part pandemic-induced interest and 25th year nostalgia for the Pokemon franchise. Professional Sports Authentication service that specializes in trading cards announced Tuesday that it is pausing operations to get a handle on its backlog of cards. Interest in both Pokemon cards and sports cards have surged during the pandemic, and PSA has way too many cards to go through. In a statement to Polygon, a PSA representative said the company has been overrun with card submissions, noting that Pokemon cards are certainly part of that. Our records show that Pokemon card submissions have increased steadily over the past 10 years, but never more so than in the past 12 months. PSA spokesperson Terry Melia said, for example, more than 1 million Pokemon cards were submitted to PSA for grading in 2020, and already in just the first three months of 2021, we are on track to quadruple that amount this year. So then they're talking about getting 4 million cards in 2021 if they weren't holding back, if they didn't stop and halt production on all this stuff. It would have been up to 4 million Pokemon cards after doing 1 million in 2020. And I did read a stat that said that Pokemon in 2019, that PSA finally graded their 1 millionth Pokemon cards. So it took all those years up until 2019 to grade 1 million Pokemon cards, and then all of a sudden 2020 hit, you get an additional 1 million that hits the market. And then if they wouldn't have halted things in 2021, they would be on pace to be doing 4 million Pokemon cards just this year, which is absolutely insane. PSA is the largest and most trusted card grading service in the world. According to its website, it's created a 10-point system to rate trading cards after they're authenticated. It starts at PSA Pour and goes up to PSA Gem Mint 10, a ranking that means the card is virtually perfect. I'm not going to go into too much more about this because you can read the article on your own. If you haven't already, I'll leave a link for it in the description down below. But I did want to take a look at some of the population reports and get a better understanding of where PSA right now is as far as grading goes. And to first start off, we're going to go over to the PSA website and just kind of look over pricing to get a card graded, just to get you a better understanding of what I'm talking about when I say junk slab. So I do have a PSA card right here. I do like the label for a PSA graded card. I like it more than pretty much everything else, which is kind of what I think a lot of people are in the same boat of. I think people really prefer the PSA slab, and that's why a lot of people tend to use PSA more regularly. It's just better recognized in the industry. But if we're looking at the costs of getting a card graded, let's say you go out, and a lot of people were sending a lot of cards that were WotC cards, so cards from Base, Jungle, Fossil, from Commons and Uncommons all the way up to Holographic Rares, they were sending them in to get graded. And when you can buy, you know, near mint copies of all these cards on TCG Player or on eBay or on a different website for, you know, 50 cents to a dollar for a lot of Commons and Uncommons, going and getting this card graded for an additional $20, not including the membership fee just to join, that just seems kind of crazy, because you're taking a near mint card and yeah, you got it encapsulated, yeah, you got it graded, but I don't know if you're really increasing the value up to $20.50 for that card that you bought for 50 cents. And when I was looking at eBay sold listings and looking at a lot of other things, there's a lot of people who have lost a decent chunk of money just kind of grading slabs that should have never been graded to begin with. And I do think it is important to grade what's important to you and to collect what's important to you. But at the same time, I think we kind of let greed overcome us a lot over the past year. And a lot of misinformation got spread out there thinking that we should be grading anything and everything, and that we can turn around and flip it overnight and it'll be, you know, this big, huge gain overnight, and it's just not the case. So if we're looking at getting PSA graded cards done, first you have to pay a membership fee. So you're going to pay a membership fee of about $100, and that'll give you a few free grades. That $100 fee is on a yearly basis. It gives you a few free grades, and that's pretty much it. But then you also have to pay to get cards graded on top of that. So you have a $20 per card for the value service that PSA provides. That's suspended right now. Same thing with the economy, which is $50, and the regular service, which is $100. Those three are all suspended right now. PSA did recently open back up the Express, Super Express, and Walkthrough, but look at how much you're paying per card. So if you pull, let's say, that Mew, that gold Mew that we're all suspecting is going to be in Celebrations, if you want to get it graded right away, you're paying $200 just to get it graded Express. And yes, that will definitely change the market, but it's, I mean, that's a crazy amount to go hope that you have a card that's going to come back as a Gem Mint 10. And a lot of times there's this thing that people think of as soon as they open up a booster pack that it's going to be a Gem Mint 10, and that's not necessarily the case. A lot of times, I would say probably 90% of the time when you open up a booster pack, you're looking at a 9. Very rarely is it going to fetch a 10 right out of the gates. It does happen, but it's not nearly it doesn't happen nearly as often as what a lot of people are claiming that it does happen, which is an important thing to remember. $200 a card, $300 a card for Super Express, and then the Walkthrough, which is $600 a card. When we look through the complete through dates of where the PSA is right now, the thing that boggled me was if you're looking at the value TCG grades, which is up until October of last year, they're only 11% of the way done for the cards up until October of last year. So if you're somebody who sent off cards into PSA and chose the value option, meaning, hey, it's going to take, usually what they advertised at the time was about 6 months is what it seemed like we were getting PSA cards back. They're only 11% done with those cards up until the month of October. And we are already 10 months after that. So you're looking at probably a year on the strong side of things that it's going to take to get those cards back. If you submitted, you know, kind of at the end of summer last year, beginning of fall, October of last year, they're only 11% of the way through, which is absolutely crazy to me. But I do want to look over, I did kind of take a look at the population report just to get a better understanding of where all these graded cards are coming from. So if we look at the base set, the original set that came out in 1999, you're looking at 275,905 graded cards, which is a lot and substantially more than any other set. Now, the thing to remember about the population report when it comes to PSA graded cards is that 275,905, that makes up First Edition, that makes up Shadowless, and that makes up Unlimited Base. So there's three different variants. And also, in comparison to the Jungle set, the Fossil set, and the Team Rocket set, there's quite a few more base cards in existence than there was of Jungle, Fossil, and Team Rocket, because there's 102 cards in the base set, as opposed to Jungle, which only has like 64 cards, Fossil, which has a little bit more than that, and then Team Rocket, I think, has 82 cards or something like that. So there is not a whole lot of cards in Jungle, Fossil, and Team Rocket compared to base. There should be more cards that are getting graded, but 275,905 is a lot, and it seems like a lot of those have happened over the past year and a half, somewhere around there. If we go to the next generation and go to Neo Genesis, you're looking at 7,641 cards that have been graded, total population. So compare that to 275,905. That's an insane difference right there. Neo Discovery, there's just over 13,500. Neo Revelations, there's almost 7,000. And then Neo Destiny, a set that is very popular, and you've got a lot of shining cards in that set. Neo Destiny, you're looking at 25,357 cards that have been graded so far as a total population from that set. Expedition, there's 17,995 cards graded. Aquapolis, 15,305. And Skyridge, which was an underprinted set by because it was the last of the Wizards of the Coast set that came out. So a lot of people, it's a very important set. 23,661 cards. So a lot of cards graded. I do expect these numbers here, to not go up as much as what you'll see Neo Genesis go up, Neo Discovery go up, Neo Revelation, Neo Destiny, and then Jungle, Fossil, Team Rocket. I do expect those to really balloon up over the next few months here as we start getting a lot more submissions back from that late summer, early fall push from last year. But then if you start looking at some of the newer modern sets, if you go to the XY era, only 2,000 cards from XY base have been into PSA's population. Flashfire, which features the Charizard EX, the entrance of Charizard EX, 7,924. So 7,924. Furious Fists, which is where you saw cards like Lucario EX, Seismitoad EX, you've got 1,434 as a total population. That is a very, very small portion, making up that million dollar, or that million card range for PSA. But if you look at Evolutions from XY, which is obviously the most popular XY set by far, you're looking at almost 58,000 graded cards right now. And that number is going to continue to climb and climb and climb. And what does that do to the Evolution set? Well, we've seen it. We've witnessed it a lot over the past few months now as Charizard continues to fall down further and further. That's going to be the case with a lot of different graded cards from the Evolution set. As more come out of the market, that's obviously going to decrease those prices down. So all the people who are spending additional money getting all these cards graded, thinking it's going to help the value of their card, it might actually do the opposite because it's just more coming into the market then. If you look at Sun and Moon, which is the next generation after that, Sun and Moon Base, 8,439. Guardians Rising, there's 8,098. Burning Shadows, 12,142. Obviously, that's a big set because of the that's your first appearance of the Rainbow Rare Charizard GX. And then Unbroken Bonds, which is what we actually had right here that I showed you guys before. This is the appearance of the Reshiram and Charizard GX. So there is 11,856. Here's the numbers that I really want to pay attention to because this shows you how things have gone over the past year. And this means a lot of people are probably paying that extra price to get cards back much quicker. They're not doing the value rate or anything like that, because if they did the value rate on Vivid Voltage, chances are they wouldn't even have that product back yet. If we're only 11% of the way done with submissions through October and Vivid Voltage didn't even come out until October, November of last year, that means that it wouldn't even have been available to send out by October of last year. So if we look at Sword and Shield Base, 8,403, Rebel Clash, 4,138, Darkness Ablaze, I should have looked at the amount of Charizard VMAXs that were graded from Darkness Ablaze, because I'm sure that makes up the majority of this right here, 8,445. Champion's Path. And this is an important one because that came out in September of last year, which means there's a lot of cards that are out there that kind of are still on the fence whether or not they're going to get back if people submitted them for that value turnaround. Champion's Path has 17,566 cards that are graded. 12,000 of them are Charizards. 12,000. And there's only two Charizards in that set, if you remember correctly. There's that shiny Charizard V and then the Charizard V Max, the Rainbow Rare. 12,000, one of them had like 6,500 and one of them had like 5,500. So 12,000 of these 17,000 cards are Charizards, which is insane to me. And then Vivid Voltage, you have 11,067. So what I'm looking at when I see these numbers is you see these higher numbers for the previous sets, and that means that a lot of people are probably playing for more of an express turnaround when it comes to this. But if you look at how these numbers, this is just 1 year, you know, basically of when these cards came out, because Sword and Shield Base is only a few years old now. These numbers are already surpassing what you saw in the Sun and Moon era and already surpassing what you saw in a lot of the X and Y sets. So that means that a lot of these cards that are getting graded now, if you look, Neo Genesis has been out for, what, 22 years, 21 years, and it's only at 7,641 graded cards. That means that the when you start looking at the attention that has been given to grading from a value aspect and why it's so important, it's really, really blown up over the past year. And that goes back to what we saw with the Polygon article and everything like that. So I was curious to get everybody's opinion on what you thought about the PSA graded market or the graded market and what you think it's doing to cards. Personally, I do like the idea of grading cards. I think it's a great thing to do if you're collecting what you want to collect and you're putting it away for long term and you just want to be able to have it to look at and you want to protect the condition of cards. So if you're somebody who's like, well, I really want to get, you know, a first edition Shadowless set done and I want to get them all graded and they don't all have to be PSA 10s, that's fine. It's okay if they're PSA 3, PSA 4, PSA 5, because I don't want them to get any worse condition than that. That's totally okay. But if you're somebody who's like, hey, I've got this Seeking from XY Breakthrough that I want to get graded, and it looks like it's going to get a 10, then, I mean, why? Why are you getting it graded? What's the importance of it? Because ultimately, all you're doing is you're paying extra money to get this card graded, and it's not going to be worth anything near that unless it's really important to you. So I wanted to hear what everybody thought about all these graded cards that are going to start coming back in the market, and really wanted to just make people aware of what's going on with the PSA market out there. I think that there are other options out there, obviously, for getting cards graded. There's other companies, middleman services that you can go through. Let me know what you think of the grading process down below. And I just wanted to throw together some data just to kind of give you an idea of where grading has come from where it first began. So with that being said, hope you guys are all doing well. I've rambled for long enough now, but make sure to leave a thumbs up, leave a like on the video, leave a comment down below to help with the algorithm and let me know what you think, guys. Thank you so much. Most importantly, hit that subscribe button. I appreciate you guys very, very much, and I will talk to you soon. Peace.